Welcome, dear brothers and sisters, and all who are assisting this sermon. We have arrived at the first letter of Peter, chapter 3. Likewise, your wives, be submissive to your husbands, so that some, though they do not obey the word, may be won without a word by the behavior of their wives when they see you reverent and chaste behavior. Let not yours be the outward adorning with braiding of hair, decoration of gold, and wearing of robes, but let it be the hidden person of the heart with the imperishable jewels of a gentle, a quiet spirit, which in God's sight is very precious. So once the holy women who hoped in God used to adorn themselves and were submissive to their husband, as Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord, and you are now her children, if you do right, and let nothing terrify you. Likewise, your husbands, live considerately with your wives, bestowing honor on the woman as the weaker sex, since you are joint heirs of the grace of life, in order that your prayer will not be hindered. Whew. Heavy words, and especially nowadays, they misinterpret these words, they do not explain them correctly, so I hope to make one another clear to you. Likewise, verse 1, referring to chapter 2, to verse 13, be subject for the Lord's sake to every human institution. The emperor, kings, presidents, judges, and verse 18, servants, be submissive to your masters with all respect, not only to the kind and gentle, but also to the overbearing. Jesus, he was submissive to God his Father. Although he was God, he was equal to God the Father. He was submissive to the will of God his Father until the death on the cross. So, likewise, your wife, be submissive to your husbands. Out of this context, we understand that we are talking here about unbelievers, husbands who do not and reject Jesus Christ. Even in those cases, the wife must be submissive and win the husband for Jesus, not by proclaiming the gospel, but through the acts, the deeds, by showing a pure, clean life. Through a reverent and chaste behavior, you can win your husband, your unbelieving husband, by being an ambassador of Jesus Christ in your daily life, showing your love for your husband, for your children, taking good care of the household, cleaning the house without reclamations, showing by reading the Bible, by prayer, showing your respect for God. And if your husband tells you not to go to church, I don't have an answer. I think personally you shouldn't go to church, but read the Bible, prayer. And if your husband forbids you to read the Bible, to prayer, do it when he is on work. Take your time, close the door of your room and read the Bible and pray. Don't let that relation with God be disturbed. Because that is what Satan wishes, that you stop all your activity, your study, and your communication, your relation with God the Father and Jesus Christ. Let the Holy Spirit guide you. Submissive, that isn't of this age, Wilfred. Men and women are equal. Men and women both work, but look to what it is leading to. The children receive incorrect and non-Christian teaching on schools, in crashes, drugs, suicide, stealing, murder. The youth is lost. They don't receive the attention because father and mother, they return tired on home after working. They don't have the time for the children. The children are missing the love of their parents. My opinion, the wife is a mother. The children need the mother. It is not good when the mother is working and the children are still young. And when children are going to school, during school time, the mother can work. The mother can work nowadays from home. Be there for the children. That's showing love, the love of God for his children. And wife and husband, they need to talk about things. Jesus talked with his father in prayer. The father spoke with his son. But the son, Jesus, remained submissive. The husband, he need to lead. He need to take care of his family, provide food, a house. That is his responsibility. Giving love to his wife, treat her well, not be harsh. That's Christian life. That's what the Christian wife needs to show. And then verse 3. Let not yours be the outward adorning with braiding of hair, decoration of gold, and wearing of robes. We are talking about the age of Peter. The braiding of hair in that time was especially by prostitutes. The prostitutes with decoration of gold, of robes, showing the breast, mini robes, sewing with glitter, wearing ear bells of gold, especially in those days. the prostitution of women and men at the temples of the idols. And don't forget Queen Esther of the Bible book Esther. She had beautiful robes wearing gold, the woman of the Old Testament. But here we are talking about the period of Peter, with all those idols, all those prostitution at the idol temples. So it isn't forbidden to be attractive for your husband, but when you are going to church, you're dressed to the honor of God. You wear robes to the honor of God. Not tiered, but to the honor of God. And by doing so, by showing when you are outside the house, the woman dressed modestly, and she can win her unbelieving husband. Submissive, verse 6, as Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord. That was normal in those days, that wives called their husband Lord. Nowadays, that's not of the order. But Sarah obeyed Abraham. When Abraham was called by God to leave his country Ur and to go to a country which God would show him. And Sarah, she was submissive. She followed Abraham. She didn't stay in that rich country where they had a lot of wealth. No, she followed Abraham, following the call of God. And Sarah, she obeyed Abraham very much. When Abraham told her, when they left the promised land Israel, because of the hunger, the famine, they went to Egypt. And Abraham told, don't say that I'm your husband. Tell all those people that you are my sister. It was a half line. She was his half sister. Sarah obeyed, I think, incorrectly, and Abraham was wrong in that 2 times. But she obeyed. She was submissive. Are you the sister of Sarah, believing in God? And then, verse 7, likewise you, husband, likewise. Remember Peter, chapter 2, the verses 13 and 18? Obedient, submissive to God. Verse 7, likewise your husband, live considerately with your wives. Bestow on the woman as the weaker sex. Other translation has the weaker vessel. A vessel, when it drops on the ground, it breaks in pieces. A woman? Yes, she is a weaker sex. She doesn't have those muscles as a man nowadays. By all those training, some women are strong. Remember Rebecca, who poured water for the camels? but emotionally a woman is weaker. A man, he can put aside things. He's created, may I say so, without many emotions. But the woman, she is more emotionally. She needs to be, because she needs to care about the children. So, we men, we need to be strong in difficult situations and take care of our wife. Give her love, honor her, because we are heirs, joint heirs of the grace of life. Men need to believe in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. And the same is true for the woman. She needs to believe in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. Equally to inherit eternal life. Jesus, he was submissive to God the Father, but they were equal. And why we men need to be honoring our wives? Because if we do not treat well, if we mistreat our wives, God will not listen to our prayers. God will tell us husbands, love your wife first. Love your neighbor as yourself. And our wife is our neighbor. We need to take care of her. Love her. Jesus went to the cross because he loved his bride, the church, and died for the sin of men. Are you willing to give your life for your wife? For your children? Think about it. Think about what it means to be submissive. Think about what it means to love your wife. Take care of her. Take good care of her like Jesus took good care of the church. May God open your eyes. I hope that this preaching will help you to understand correctly in its context what is the meaning of these verses, the meaning and in the context of the age, the period the Apostle Peter was living. Understand well what Peter is telling to your wives and to us husbands. May God bless you in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.